Hello again, my name is Lenny and welcome to my world of model aircraft. And on this video, I'm going to be doing a bit of this in a moment outside with the P-51. Everything is off, ready for going, for primer. The Mustang itself, all shaved down. Let me just move my coffee out of the way. All the seam lines are down, everything else is rock and roll. All I'm going to do is just wait for this Mr. Surfacer to just dry off, and I'll take it off. Okay, to hopefully give it a wipe down, and again go for primer, and hopefully, fingers crossed, we might have a lick of paint on it, but I'm not promised anything, and I don't know exactly what's all going to be on this video. But anyway, bit of good news. Some of you may have read it already. This turned up. The bloody windshield. Now, I know what happened. What happened was, a little pixie came in and nicked it and went, and ran off with it. And that's the God's honest truth. That's what actually happened. But in reality, what did happen, I used, believe it or not, the bread bin, which is a little bin that you put bread in. Whatever country you're from probably won't know what a bread bin is. Anyway, it's about that big, that tall. And what I use it for is to put the iPad on, turn it around so I'm looking at an angle so you can see what I'm doing. Well, the canopy was there as well. So what I've done is I thought, right, let's go and clear up. Whoosh, that's gone. Put it in there, blah, 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 blah. And it, obviously the windshield's gone. And I went to make a sandwich myself in the kitchen. What I've done is I've taken the breadboard out, which is right next to the bread bin, and it's doing this. You know when you sort of look at something, you're like, for that sort of like microsecond, you're thinking, what am I looking at? Oh yeah, yes, ace. Then you sort of go, that you found it. So I'm happy now. So the kit's complete. So all I'm going to do now, I'm not going to bore you with watching me going prime, all that kind of stuff. I'm going to crack on with it, get it done as quick as I can, let it dry properly, and hopefully a bit of bish bash bosh. So enough of my waffle, because it's nearly 3 minutes. Go, do something interesting, and I'll come back in a minute. Go on, shoot. Right, chaps, I'm back. Everything's done, everything's primed. I'm just ready to rock and roll now on the silvering, or the silver, shall I say. And there you go, there's the P-51, and she is ready to go. I do have a slight bit here to do with the seam, but I'm not overly that bothered, really. It's okay, tiny, tiny little bit, but that's fine. I'm not going to beat around the bush about it and go... Anyway, paints, what am I going to be using for the paints? Nothing fancy, no flim flam, no thinking, woo. As in, I'm not going to be using anything like Alclads for a very, very good reason. I don't have any. But what I do have is a selection of Tamiya paints, which I'm going to be using XF16, which is the flat aluminium. I also have chrome silver, which to me looks pretty much the same as the flat aluminium, but I do have an XF56, which is a metallic grey. Now that to me looks a little bit too dark for the other panel, so what I might do is just add, say, a mix of, say, 70 to 30 or 80 to 20 on this, just to darken it up just a little bit. Nothing too in your face job, but that's what I'm going to be doing. So without further ado, there's the Mustang, there's my paints, there's my everything else. Let's crack on with it. Go on over there. Right, what I'm going to do is just start on the bottom, because what I want to do is just get all the bottom done, sorted out, sort the undercarriage up so I can actually stick it on its legs, just to try and save, you know, the arse-ache of not getting bits and pieces all over it. But the first thing I've noticed straight away, and this is the first time I've ever sprayed anything silver, literally, on an aircraft like this, or anything really, is the coverage that you get in. And I'm not doing it particularly thick at all. Is that it's quite, well, it's got a lot of coverage on it already. So if you are airbrushing, just keep a mental note that it doesn't take an awful lot to get a good coverage. It's probably a lot, I don't know what the light is at the moment, but I don't know if you'll be able to see, it's probably all the coverage of it, because basically it's going on, well, a grey to a silver. But for me at the moment, I'm looking at it and it's, although I can see the silver, but there isn't that much of a difference of a transformation between the grey primer and the actual silver, if you know what I mean, if that makes any sense. Probably not, but hey-o, you're not watching these videos to listen to any sense. Let me just check the camera to see if it's actually looking silver. Oh yeah, well, it's not too bad. Oh, by the way, I've got the bread bin out again. Ha ha! It's nowhere near that bloody canopy. Oh, by the way, added value vaccinations for your pets as well. Very good. I'm going to be doing, well, at the moment, from what I can see through, you know, what I can feel through the hand and when the paint's coming out of it, it is quite a thin coat. I'm not 100% sure if it's going to dry quickly, I'm not sure. But like I said, this is the first time I've ever done like a metal finish on an aircraft. So right, what I'll do is, I'll dry this down and see where we go from there. All right, see you in a bit. All right, well that's the bottom bit done. All I've done is very, very first light coat over it, let it dry, which was touch dry, well, very, very quickly. Then I've gone over it again, slightly thicker, dried it off again, didn't take very long at all. And again, just one final coat, just to go all over, just to make sure that the actual finish is quite even. So yeah, I'm happy with that. So let me just dry that off a little bit more, and I'll go in on the top bit.
Yay!
Right, bottom half done. Happy with that. So literally, I'll do exactly the same on the top. Again, just a very, very light coat. Again, I'm actually doing this, the air is coming out about 40 psi. It is quite high, yes I know. But after twiddling my knob and all the rest of it, it's something that I'm really, well, I'm happy with. It's doable for me. Oh yeah, one other thing as well. Some modeller called Nigel Wells did a Mustang. I've heard of him a couple of times, he's alright. He makes me sick. And yeah, his Mustang was okay. So I just want to put that pause in there, Nigel. Now, gentlemen, Nigel Wells, he did this. Well, he didn't actually spray it. He actually bloody foiled it with proper foil. And I can only say this, well, let me just say, spit it out, Lenny. I will, promise. Go and have a look what he did. If you haven't seen Nigel Wells' Mustang, go and have a look. Because it is something generally seeing is believing. The work and the effort that guy put into it is something else. It really, really is. It's well worth a look. So, pop down, see Nigel on his channel, and have a look at his Mustang. Please do. Anyway, Enough of his brilliance, it's time for mine. Right, this silver paint is going on really, really well. It's my normal thing which I've done, it's a 50-50 mix, it's nothing flash. I'm using Tamiya's own thinners. And if I dare say, it's going on an absolute dream. But I will just reiterate as well, if I have said it before, I can't remember if I have or not. When you're doing a bare metal finish, honestly guys, it's really important to make sure that your surface that you're spraying on is free of dirt, dust, anything that could actually sort of like ruin your finish. That is important. And what I did yesterday, once all the sanding was finished, I did my obligatory bath for the whole kit, which basically entailed not dunking it completely underwater, but getting a toothbrush with a little dab of washing up liquid and just scrubbing the whole lot, every nook and cranny, every panel line, everything, just get rid of it. And once you've done it, just run it under a tap, doesn't matter, well, don't make it too hot, but if it's a warm tap, cold tap, doesn't matter. All you're interested in is getting all the bits off. What you don't want is like having clumps of dust and all that kind of rubbish and cobblers all over it, because it will ruin your finish. Right, just bear with me. Right chaps, sorry I've overextended a little bit with the old painting. I'm hoping that we've been able to take or learn a little bits and pieces, as I've said. I'm literally just going to be doing, well, banging on with the silver work. And with all the other bits and pieces, you know, the undercarriage and flaps and all the rest of it. So that's what I'll be cracking on with now. I don't know if I'm going to do anything tomorrow, because I just had a phone call to say, oh, we've got a job for you. Temporary job, but needs must. Anyway, guys, I'll have another go at today, see if I can put anything else on camera. But yeah, I'm afraid now you're going to have to bear with me. Okay, gents, that's it. Okay, thanks very much for watching, and I shall see you on the next video. Okay, until then, bye.